Hello students of class 8, today we will be proceeding with the supplementary text. As I recall, we have already begun the chapter, The Selfish Giant. It is a very simple and touching story about a giant who has a change of heart as he comes into contact with little children. Okay, so The Selfish Giant we have already begun. Let us recapitulate the story as we have done. The story begins with children playing in a beautiful garden with birds twittering around them, the flowers blooming around them. So it's a scene of beauty and tranquility. And then this peace the children enjoys inside the garden, the happiness that they enjoy inside the garden, is disturbed with the return of a giant who comes back after 7 years. Okay, so he comes and then he prohibits the children from entering his garden. He tells them that you are not allowed to come, you are not allowed to play in here because this garden is my property. Okay, he even puts up a signboard in which it is written trespassers will be prosecuted. As a result of this, even spring refuses to come, even autumn refuses to come into his garden, and he just have everlasting winter. Okay, he just has everlasting winter in his garden. Along with winter, because of the winter which always stays in his garden, snow, frost, hail and the north wind, they also come and they celebrate in their in his garden. Okay, so the giant feels really disturbed by the fact that why is spring not coming to my garden? Come to page number 19, the last paragraph. We are going to be repeating a little bit. One morning, the giant was lying awake in bed when he heard some lovely music. It sounded so sweet to his ears that he thought it must be the king's musicians passing by. Okay, so one day, the giant was lying awake in bed. Lying awake in bed means he was still, he was not sleeping, but he was simply lying in bed. Okay, and he was simply lying in bed when he heard some lovely music. A lovely music was heard by the giant. And he thought that maybe the king's musicians were just moving on the street. It was really only a little linnet singing. A bird singing outside his window. Linnet is a songbird, okay, a small songbird, and he thought that it's the lovely music which he heard was probably coming from the king's musician, but it was actually a small bird who was singing. But it was so long since he had underlined this portion. But it was so long since he had heard a bird singing in his garden that it seemed to him to be the most beautiful music in the world. Okay, so underline this portion. If the question comes, why did the music of the bird seem so magical to the giant, you will have to write this answer, that because it was so long since he had heard any bird singing that it seemed to be the most magical, the most beautiful melody in the world. Then the hail stopped dancing over his head. That means the sound of hailstorms, the pellets of rain, okay, the pellets of hails which were falling on his roof, that sound stopped. That means hail stopped dancing in his garden. Okay, that sound which was happening because of the continuous hail, it stopped. And the north wind ceased roaring. Ceased means stopped. The north wind even stopped or ended. Okay, it was not blowing anymore. And a delicious perfume came to him through the open casement. Through the open window, a delicious smell reached his ear. I believe the spring has come at last, said the giant, and he jumped out of bed and looked out. So he said he was so happy with the fact that maybe spring had at last come to his garden. And so he sprang up from his bed and he sat up. And he looked out. Come to the second section. Look at the picture which is given us. In this picture you can see that the selfish giant is looking on. And in his garden, a number of trees are there which are green in color. And the little children are playing here and there. There are birds, there are flowers. So it's a beautiful sight. He saw a most wonderful sight. Okay, this part is also important. The question might come, what was the scene which greeted the giant as he looked out of his room? He saw through a little hole in the wall the children had crept in. Crept in means crawled in. Okay, like little children do. So they had crawled through that hole in the garden. And they were sitting in the branches of the trees. They were sitting everywhere in the garden. In every tree that he could see, there was a little child. And the trees were so glad to have the children back again that they had covered themselves with blossoms. That means nature was in full glory. All the trees, they loved having the children back in the garden. And so the trees were all full of blossoms. Okay. Blossoms means flowers. And were waving their arms gently above the children's heads. It's as if the trees were like humans and they were waving their hands just to show the children that they were happy to have them back. The birds were flying about and twittering with delight. They were chirping. The birds were chirping. They were giving call out to each other. And because they were also very happy, they were also calling each other. And the flowers were looking up through the green grass and laughing. Okay, the flowers had also blossomed and they were looking up through the green grass. The flowers were also blooming and they were laughing. That means the flowers were also very happy to have the children back. It was a lovely scene. Only in one corner it was still winter. There was just a corner in the garden where winter was still there. It was the farthest corner of the garden. Farthest means the most far place of the garden. And in it was standing a little boy. A small boy was standing there. He was so small that he could not reach up to the branches of the tree. Okay, so there was a small boy who was there. And he was so small, so tiny in height that he could not even reach out to the branches of the tree. Because he also wanted to climb up the tree, but he could not. And he was wandering all around it, crying bitterly. So he was moving around that tree. Wandering means he was moving around in that tree, in that region. And he was crying in a bitter fashion. That means he was very hurt. He was very angry because he couldn't climb the tree. The poor tree was still covered with frost and snow. And the north wind was blowing and roaring above it. Because the child was not able to climb the tree had not had a contact with the child. And so it was still winter in that area. Okay. So, and the north wind was also blowing over there. "Climb up, little boy," said the tree. And it bent its branches down as low as it could. But the boy was too tiny. Even the tree wanted the boy to climb up its branch. But the boy was so tiny that he couldn't take the branches. And the giant's heart melted as he looked out. Melted. Okay, he had a change of heart. His heart changed and he was full of affection for the little boy. "How selfish I have been," he said. "Now I know why the spring would not come here." So remember the context. Remember the point in the story when the giant realizes his mistake. Okay, so get this portion in bracket. And remember that this is the place, this is the situation which brings in a change of heart of the giant. Okay. "I will put that poor little boy on the top of the tree and then I will knock down the wall. And my garden shall be the children's playground forever and ever." So such a beautiful transformation the giant had. He was really very sorry for what he had done. So he resolves to mend his manners, to change his manners, and he resolves to break down the walls of the garden. He resolves to change himself and he says that his garden will be the playground for children for eternity. So he crept downstairs. That means he moved quietly downstairs and opened the front door quite softly. Without making much sound, he opened the front door and went out into the garden. But when the children saw him, they were so frightened that they all ran away. Because they still had that picture of the giant shouting at them angrily. In the beginning of the story, remember? So they were obviously afraid. They were little children and the garden became winter again. The moment the children left, the garden again changed into winter landscape. Only the little boy did not run, for his eyes were so full of tears that he did not see the giant coming. And the giant stole up behind him and took him gently in his hands and put him up into the tree. So the giant was very carefully, very slowly he went towards the little boy and slowly he took him gently in his hand. In a very gentle fashion he handled the little boy and put him up into the tree. That means he helped him climb the tree. And the tree broke at once into blossom. The tree started flowering. And the birds came and sang on it. And the little boy stretched out his two arms and flung them round the giant's neck and kissed him. Okay, so the little boy was so happy with the act of kindness by the giant that he reflected his happiness by kissing him. And the other children, when they saw that the giant was not wicked any longer, came running. So the other children also came back to the garden. And with them came the spring. "It is your garden now, little children," said the giant. And he took a great axe and knocked down the wall. And when the people were going to market at 12 o'clock, they found the giant playing with the children in the most beautiful garden they had ever seen. So everybody, as they were going to the market, that means it was a normal daytime, and as they were moving to the market, they saw that the giant was sitting there in the garden. He was playing with the garden, playing with the children. And it was a beautiful garden that they had ever seen. Okay, so we will continue with this story. I hope you have enjoyed this story. If you have any difficulty in understanding, you can tell it to me.